about not telling you what I was going to say, and I wanted you to check for yourselves. Did you look in your calendars? You forgot. How many of you looked in your calendars last week? So what was the big deal this week?
Fast free.
Right. Did all of you fast on Wednesday and Friday?
No.
Do you normally?
Yes.
Good. But this was a fast-free week. Because it was also the beginning of what? No, not yet. Not yet. The triodio. The book that we use from last Sunday up until Pascha, where all of the hymns of these particular Sundays are. These are the pre-Lenten Sundays and the Lenten Sundays. So I didn't want to tell you not to fast, because I wanted to see if you would know it on your own. If you did, good. But you didn't have to. That was the point. And before I forget, I have more prayer robes, more crosses, for those of you who didn't get them last week. I'm going to ask you a question. I don't want you to answer it out loud, because it might be intimidating or incriminating. Do any of you talk to yourselves? Let me say, I do. I don't think there's a person in the world that doesn't talk to himself. If you do it a little too much, you're in trouble. But we all have this tendency to say things to ourselves. It was very interesting. A psychiatrist said, and I was thinking about this yesterday, how many of you got up and said, oh, what a terrible day. It's gloomy. It's raining. Did you say that? Don't say that. Because the psychiatrist said, when it's a terrible day, it's not really terrible unless you tell yourself that it is. And if you tell yourself that it's a terrible day, it will be a terrible day. So you get up in the morning, even if it's raining, even if it's gloomy, even if there's no sun, even if it's snowing, well, we may like the snow, even if it's icy, say, Lord, thank you for another day. How wonderful is your creation. And have a good day. Now, many years ago, Norman Vincent Peale was a very famous preacher. And he wrote a book that was condemned by many Christians and many Christian groups. It was called The Power of Positive Thinking. Because we don't make our faith through positive thinking, but there is a place for positive thinking, exactly like I said now, when you get up in the morning. Every day is a gift. It's a gift. No matter what it's doing outside, it's a gift. God has given us another day. Say, thank you, Lord. And if we remember some promises from God, or if we read the Psalms, and we remember those things that he tells us, it will make a difference in our life and in our day. For instance, with God all things are possible that are impossible with men. Or, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Of what and of whom shall I be afraid? If the Lord is with me, we have to be afraid of nothing. Or to read that the Lord is like a mother hen who keeps us under his wings. He's now a mother, protecting us with his wings. Or that he allows us to soar on wings of eagles, and that nothing can be against us. But first of all, you have to know the scriptures, and you have to know the Lord's promises in order to be able to say them. I have some booklets for you today. And some of them are precious promises from God. And I got the large print, because I need it myself. But large enough so we can all read it. Take one, read it. Familiarize yourselves with the scriptures, with the Psalms, with the Lord's promises, with his words. And get up in the morning and say, God, thank you for another day, Lord, thank you. And even if it's raining, somebody needs it, the farmers need it. If it's snowing, well, it's good because the crops will have enough water. If it's icy, well, it'll keep me in the house for a day. I don't have to go out. There's always something to be thankful for. And why Because this story is so familiar with us. It's so famous. It's so well known. But this son, who asked his father before he was even going to die, he wanted his half of the property. Now, first of all, who says that he would get it anyway? But he assumed that he would get it, and he took it, and he spent it. And there was a famine in the land, and then he's feeding pigs, and the pigs were eating better than him. So what does it say? What does the Lord tell us in the parable? He talked to himself. Now, I know some people have no other friends than themselves to talk to. But who do you get the best advice from? Yourself. Because it's been in your conscience and regurgitated. And he talked to himself, and he said, why should I go through this? Let me go back to my father and say, hey, I'm sorry, Dad. Please, take me back. Make me one of your servants. I'd be better off than what I am now. He talked to himself, and he got himself to go back to his father. And his father, who is the example of God, was looking for him every day, waiting for him to come. And he saw him in the distance, and he ran to him and brought him back. And he gave him more than he would have had if he had stayed with him. He put on a special robe, he gave him a ring, he did the battle cap, so much so that the brother who stayed was angry. But this shows us how loving our Father is, that he takes us back when we come to him, when we say, I'm sorry, when we say, I was wrong, can you forgive me? Have mercy on me. And what do you think the Father does?
No.
Stay away from me? Of course not. He takes it back with love and gives him greater grace than he would have had when he stayed. And this is what the Lord does for us. When we come to him, he accepts us and he gives us great, great gifts. He doesn't say, where have you been all these years? He doesn't say that. He doesn't say, oh, now that you meet me, you came. He doesn't say that. He says, come home. I've been waiting for you. Please, be with me, and I'll give you a big dinner on this table. He gives us that dinner and forgives us. This morning's Mass Gospel was the Road to Emmaus, a very, very special Gospel reading. The Lord had risen. He's walking with two of the disciples, not the apostles, but the disciples. They didn't recognize him. They didn't know who he was. And they said to him, are you the only stranger who doesn't know what's going on in Jerusalem? You know when they recognized him? Do you know? No, even he was talking to him, no. When he broke the bread, when he gave them communion, they were able to recognize him and know that that was the Lord. You tell me you can stay home and I can pray, but you can't break the bread. You can break a loaf of bread, it's not going to do you any good. They're talking about this bread. Only in the breaking of that bread can you know the Lord, can you recognize the Lord, can you really commune with the Lord, be intimate with him. That's the special thing. Being here and receiving his body and blood. Now you know that today is the Sunday that we always sing Amazing Grace. Because in a sense, so many of us are prodigal sons. We went away, we came back. Sometimes nobody ever left, but their heart left. They weren't there, soul and spirit. They were just going through the motions. We're all prodigal sons.